Yes.
Okay, so last week we covered, if you remember briefly, we talked about the idea of striking the iron on the way through. So as he's reaching for me or punching for me, we can mouse the bone and stuff like this, yeah? So we pretty much covered the idea of going back. What if we want to go forward and use a similar movement or similar technique going forward, yeah? Just as a warm up, we'll build onto this and we might play with other stuff as well as we go along tonight, okay? So, I'm just going to punch, I'm going to step forward this time. As you can see, by stepping forward, it gives me more options on target, aiming the ribs. So at this point, I can hit through on the ribs. Now, this is me being nice, by just kind of letting that fly. If I hit in and pull through, I'm looking for this kind of punchy in to get us through, okay? So as he steps, I'm going to meet him in the middle, from here, okay? You want this? Okay. Let's get this first, because the important thing is, as I step forward and I check, I can't just kind of walk forward at Tommy and hope for the best, because he's been hit enough and he's probably gonna want to kill me at this point. So when I step through, that's the first part, which is the most important bit. The next bit is just kind of coating or icing on the cake at this point, all right? So when you step in and go forward, that's when we get through. Get in, pull through. Doing this so far? Okay, left and right sides as usual. Get used to it. Get a couple of hits in. Don't break each other's ribs or anything else, or try and break each other's ribs. All right? Cool. The way this is kind of done is, like we said last week, I can be kind of hitting in and through. I can be hitting with the mid finger like this. It's a little uncomfortable at times. Okay?
Just like that.
It's a little uncomfortable at times to hit that way, and you can damage if you're not doing it correctly. So what I want you to do from a basic level is close your fist, as we said already, yeah? As we go through, hit them in. Let them walk onto it at this point. Essentially what you're doing is he's pushing. So be it a punch or a push, he's coming forward. Okay? So you're guiding him onto this. As you hit in, we don't like to leave him hanging on our fist. We might need a back. So if we hit, we're going to pull through. Like so. Okay? So if you think of it on slightly straight to round, not so much a hook, but straight cut out, okay? So, next step. As I step through, I'm gonna pull up to here. I'll try to do that without taking a breath on the way through. All right, so we step through. As we hit through, the fire, I'm gonna step to here. Why am I doing this? This is an off-balance position? Yes, it is. However, we're not gonna be there long enough, or we shouldn't be there long enough. So take the wind out of the sails, not literally. And then we're gonna pop up from here. We're gonna go above his leg. I can't do it from here because I'm trying to kick him in the knee. So I need to go above his knee to kick down on his knee. So as I pull, drop. That's the position we're looking for. That's the side of the foot, out like so. Okay? Yep. So pop through. As I gouge through, I pop in this position. That's gonna be my kick. As he lands, I'm gonna hit a kidney. Okay? That's a back fist. That kind of cut in and down that we do. Okay, from there, check. His hand is going to stop him from falling away. So the problem here is this knee can knock him away and I don't want that yet. So my hip, that position. From here, pull an elbow. Okay, if you manage to get the face, that's even better. I'm going to check on the shoulder. From here, so my hip, pull into this. Okay, keep your stance, don't fall over. From here then, world's your oyster really at that point. Okay, so up again. So we're going to step through. As we step through, we're going to pop them down. Pop them down from here, get this in. As I hit, step through, pull an elbow. Okay? Good with this? Another thing to note is, I'm leaving the space to show, but your hand should very definitely be here. Because if I pull back, if I do this, and he twists or turns and does something awkward, I can probably get an elbow in the groin, I can get fallen on, or something weird will happen. Okay? We want to account for as much weirdness as possible. Are we good with this? Okay, off we go. Okay, there's a difference in what we're doing on this particular technique. And again, this fits around our green belt, which is like third belt or fourth belt up. Yeah? So, what you'll notice from previous times is we step in and this, we step back and we've done barbell shots. We've always had a definite kind of heavy effect. This is a softer variety, but not a weaker variety. Okay? So, it's important that when we step, definite contact first off, be it to go forward, back, in, out. It needs to be something rather than just as someone might look from the outside and see you going, that's not what you want, okay? When you step, very definitely moving him to a position that's better for you, okay? And worse for him. From here, we fire through. The next bit, it's very easy to think that when we do the kick, we step and we kind of do this and then we kick him that way. But if you look at the position of this leg, if I kick him, I'm kicking up, not down, okay? So we're kicking down. In order to do that, we need to kick up with our leg. As he fires, this hits through. As I get through, this is coming up, my hand is going up, so is my leg. That gives me that position to go back down. If you want to use these as visual cues for yourself, that's fine. Just don't get too concerned with this type of thing, okay? You lift and pop. Some people like to play on this bit, so as we get an elbow, smack him in the face on this side. So we're holding him there, okay? Like so. As I step through the face, as I step forward, to the back of the face. Okay? From here. This is the back of the throat. Be very careful with this one, this is gonna get messy. If you're not careful. Okay? So from here. Yep. So as we hit, this is hit in, from here we're gonna hit through. As I hit, this is gonna step. Up and under. Okay? With this. So very much this is all of these kind of positions that we've been working for the past while. We step, we hit, we pull, we hit, hits back in. Now circular, you're hitting back through. At that point you want to step, you kick him, you can. That's what happens when we play. Okay. Alright? You happy with this? So we're taking this, we're kind of telling ourselves that it's on a step through right punch. Okay, so step through meaning that when Tommy fires his punch, he's going to step right through with that right leg and everyone's going to match up on one side. What if he doesn't? What if he still feeds the right punch but stays with the left forward? So what if he feeds like a cross at this point? Do we panic? Do we go, I can't do this and take a smack in the head? You don't bop them or bop them right loose, ever. That's just too good for that. So as he punches through, nothing changes for me. Tommy's in a bit of a bad position, but nothing changes for me at this point, okay? Now granted, there's sometimes a lot more coming through, maybe a lot less, depends on how he throws it, okay? As we step, this is still going to be something very uncomfortable for Tommy, okay? Now granted, the position for this is way off. That's okay, because he's still got one knee over here. Yeah? At this point, still do a lot to him. Okay? So, if they're on the other side, yes, you can do that. If they're on the other side, it doesn't matter. So if the leg is back, who cares? Alright? Technique remains as the technique should be, just he's not in the right position. I can still hit what I need to hit. Okay? So, don't panic too much if it's off a good leg or a bad leg. And sometimes it's nice when we're playing with these techniques. Yes, we're giving ourselves a nice ideal position where he steps through and he hits this. That's great. What if he's uninitiated, let's call it? He decides to fire and keep that back. Am I going to go, no, attack me properly? No. Deal with it. Then worry about the kind of the extra little bits later on. Okay? You good with this? Alright. So, in the essence of dealing with it, you're going to attack me properly. Okay? So, this time, let's look at that Tommy is coming at me with attempted grab, choke, whatever you want to call it, two hands. Okay? So we're going to do similar, but in a slightly different way. So as it comes through, that's the first position there. So we would have seen this last week, we would have seen this last, or this week. As we step back, this is coming down. Okay? This is still covering. This is going to check. From here. Plant it. You remember this? Okay. Now, how do we kick? Not with our toes. Toes important. So if I do this, I'm probably going to break something. I'm kicking with the ball of my foot pretty much like that. As if I'm pushing with the ball of my foot. The bit here, the pads. Okay? So again, as he feeds, I'm going to step back. You'll notice that this hand is very necessary because even if I clear one, the other is still coming. So it's important that we take this thing out of both. Like so. There's that catch there. Okay? Elbow down, not up. Because he'll pull. Elbow down, a little stronger. And then he's pulling my kick in. With So we kick. Front out. You look at this. Okay. Let's try that. Class. I want everyone to do this. Now try and get the front leg and kick properly. Yeah. No. Okay. Everyone see the issue here? It's like taking an elastic band and kind of stretching it around something and expecting it to go back. It's going to be really, really functional. Yeah. No. Okay. So when we step back, upright. Okay. If I do this. This is a collapsed structure, which means there's nothing here either. But here, I can kick, I can punch, I can do whatever I want to do from that position. If I'm punched over, I'm very limited in what I can do, and realistically, its effectiveness is probably not there at all. Alright? So when we step back, we're staying and keeping our posture. What changes here is his posture. Because if you think about it, we lean forward, we can't lift his leg. If he leans forward, he can't lift that leg. Make sense? Alright, so don't do what you want to create in him. Alright? Probably not a good step to take. So when we hit, there's our pop here. Sorry, that was a little much. Alright, so as we land through, I get excited, what can I say? From here, fire through. I'm coming through on this one. Okay? Good with this so far? Yes? Alright. So we're happy enough that we can fire that punch, yeah? Great. Now we're going to step through with that punch. As we kick, we're going to land, we're going to step through. Drive through on that. Okay? Yeah. There's a lot more we can do. If we keep control, we can dog in here. We can strike in, we can step. Take it down, pop it down, take it, stop it, stop it. And go into orange belt. Which we might see. Okay? For now. Step back. Take this shot. Okay, from here, kick up and under. And then from here, along. You good with this? Yeah? Sweet. Let's do that. Walking around, already you see people thinking and you see people going, what next? Okay? Which is always a good thing. Alright? Not what next as in, what's this guy going to do for another 26 moves? But more, what can I do next? Okay? What's ultimately what's an option? Alright? So, same thing, time comes forward, I take this from here, as far to here. Alright? Everyone is happy that we're stepping forward and we feel okay with this, yeah? Okay. Target next. Anybody? Yeah, one and two I know what it is, okay? If not, fine. Okay? Point is, you see an option. Okay? Alright? Explore the option. That's important. Don't just kind of go, oh, wait till I'm told what to do next. That's not how this should work. I can give you guidance, we can all give you guidance. The problem with it is, you need to figure it out in some ways what your options are next. And sometimes it's a good reaction that makes the most sense. Okay? You can fire from any position you want, but if it doesn't feel right, then it's not right. It's not taking a long time. When I fire through, I've seen this, so I'm going to carry with this. As I hit through, this is going to hit. So let's wrap it all together. As I hit through, I drop, go back to where we were before. Okay? Just to put it in a package. But there are many, many other things that I've already shown where you can go into other techniques. Once you're in a recognizable position, there's a number of things you can do. You can fire any number of these techniques. You can fire any number of these techniques. All of this stuff you've already seen. The important part of this lesson is, this is a shape. When we're putting it together, the lesson. This is a shape. This is a shape I'm familiar with. What I take from here is what I know. Okay? If I can react to that, then we're fine. If you're already thinking that way, half the battle is done for us. Because now it means that you're not just waiting for us to go, okay, what's on the list? It's what can I do next to end it? Alright? So, we're on it together. So we're not through, we can't. From here, we're elbow back in, and we're back to where we were. You go with this? Okay? One of the couple of minutes.